What is a constellation? When you hear the word constellation, you might picture patterns of dots that are painted across the black sky. Some may think of mythical heroes and creatures that have been placed in the sky by ancient gods because of their legendary accomplishments. However, in modern astronomy, a constellation refers to a particular region of the sky in which groups of stars appear to be grouped together. These regions of the sky look more like borderlines of countries instead of ancient beings. However, many people can easily recognize these ancient figures like Orion, the Hunter, or Scorpius, the Scorpion. Constellations have been reconfigured in some ways over modern times, but in essence, the ancient patterns can still be recognized today. The stories and shapes of constellations will vary depending on who is looking at them. For example, Ursa Major, which contains the asterism called the Big Dipper, has also been known to be called the Great Bear. Or perhaps you see this version of the bear. Or maybe you just see a plow instead. Remember that the story and shape of each constellation will vary depending upon each culture and what each individual sees. Most ancient civilizations, like the Babylonians, the Greeks, the Romans, and the Native Americans, lived in the Northern Hemisphere, so they were only able to label stars that were visible in the northern latitudes. Greco-Egyptian astronomer Ptolemy identified and cataloged more than 1,000 stars and 48 different constellations. Once European explorers started navigating their way through the southern hemisphere in the 16th century, stars in the southern skies began to be identified and cataloged. These southern constellations are known as the modern constellations, and they show far less imagination than their northern counterparts. These southern patterns were named after friends, patrons, and inventions of the time. For example, the constellation Antlia represents the air pump. It was named in the 17th century after physicist Robert Boyle, who invented the compressed air pump. The names of the southern constellations seem to have a lot less ingenuity when comparing it to the glorious northern constellations. To eliminate confusion, the International Astronomical Union gathered together in 1929 to solidify the boundaries of the constellations. Today, 88 constellations are universally recognized. Remember, constellations are rectangular slices of the sky that hold stars within that boundary. So why learn about the sky? There is much value in learning about the stars. It gives us a connection to the past, but it also paves the way for the future. As younger generations learn and pass on their knowledge, hopefully more people will become inspired to venture beyond the Earth and learn about these vast regions of space that have been viewed for thousands of years. In the past few decades, with the development of advanced technology, humans have increasingly become disconnected from these ancient stories and patterns in the sky. Not to mention that light pollution from modern civilization has blocked out many of these magnificent celestial objects. Let's review what we know. First, constellations are rectangular regions of the sky that contain patterns and shapes of stars. These stars look like they're grouped together, but in reality, there lies much distance between each individual star. A total of 88 constellations are recognized in modern times. The folklore and myths surrounding the constellations varies from culture to culture. Constellations are a way to connect globally by sharing the stories and myths that have been passed down through generations.